I'd like to thank you all for a great day so far. I would kindly ask Nikos Tsakos to come and introduce our honoree, Mr. Papagiannopoulos.
Well, I don't think you need a very big introduction, Tassos. It gives me a great pleasure to introduce Anastassios, as we all know him, Tassos Papagiannopoulos, amongst other things, the retiring chairman of BIMCO, and I want to introduce him for the very few of you who do not know him. With Tassos, we have shared common efforts in the various international forum and round tables that we discussed earlier during my Intertanko chairmanship, trying for the better, for the common good. And thank you for that. But also, when we were both a bit younger, we shared the ups and downs of the Swiss Alps and tennis courts. That was before Federer came around, of course, and put a stop into it. Tassos is really the modern Renaissance man. He represents the traditional Hyotiko, Heian, on-hands operational excellency combined with a vast educational background and knowledge of shipping and economic affairs. From all of us, we want to thank you for all the time you have put for the common good, and I would like to introduce Dr. Tassos Papagiannopoulos. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, please allow me to express my sincere gratitude to the organizers of the Capital Link for the award I just received. For many consecutive years, Olga and Nicholas Bornozis and their team succeeded through the Capital Link conferences to put emphasis on the major problems of international shipping. Besides, receiving the award from Nick Tsakos has a special dimension for me. He's a guy that I never quite managed to beat in tennis. When we used to play during the Christmas holidays some 35 years ago, a very tough and competitive young man determined not to lose, a real son of Kardamila Kios. The present award comes near the end of a trajectory proceeding through three homocentric circles: a family company, the UGS, and BIMCO. A process starting from the elementary unit to the global arena. This is a characteristic feature of the average Greek ship owner, to participate with one's full powers in all three processes. The Greek family company is the elementary unit structured on the basis of a few fundamental principles. My word is my bond. Take good care of your employees, both on shore and at sea. When things are bad, do not lose your heart. When things are good, do not lose your mind. The sea becomes ill, but never dies. I was blessed to learn these simple principles from people like my late father-in-law, G.M. Pateras, and Mr. Anthony Angelikousis. Along with my brothers-in-law, we followed these principles and we managed to weather the storm of major shipping crisis and to renew our fleet. In our efforts, we could rely on the invaluable support of our employees in the office and on the ships. They proved that the professionals in our sector constitute one fundamental factor of the flourishing of Greek shipping. To put it in a nutshell, the individual Greek company always strives to be competitive and have a reasonable return on the capital invested. This may be achieved only if we can earn the trust of the other participants in our industry, banks, charterers, insurance, and the P&I clubs. The UGS is a historical institution representing the interests of the Greek shipping in general and of its individual members in particular. The last two decades, under the leadership of capable and hard-working presidents, the UGS had some very substantial successes. A very brief summary of these successes, I can mention. One, the familiarization of the Greek public with the advantages accruing from the shipping sector. Two, the building of relations of trust with the Greek governments. Three, the protection and development of the international interests of the Greek owners. Four, the consolidation of the traditionally strong links between the ship owners and their employees. As a member of the board of directors and the executive of the UGS for a long period of more than two decades, I tried along with my colleagues to be useful and productive serving the organization. After all, as a member of the UGS, I was elected president of BIMCO in the end of a long tenure in the board of directors and the executive of the organization. BIMCO, as you know, is a global and powerful institution serving international shipping in many interlinked ways. It elaborates and publishes charter party clauses. It has a number of teaching courses for young shipping professionals. It helps the resolution of shipping disputes, and it caters for the big issues of the international shipping in cooperation with the other organizations of the round table. During my tenure as president of BIMCO, I tried to put emphasis on its substantial activities as a bridge between cultures, genders, sectors, and national interests. With the indispensable support of the Secretariat, the Board of Directors, and the Executive of BIMCO, we manage. First, to strengthen our relations with the other organizations of the Round Table. Second, to elaborate realistic policies as a reply to the environmental challenges of our times. Three, to promote the presidency of two exceptional ladies, Mrs. Adan Kapetanoglu and Mrs. Sabrina Chow, breaking the long sequence of male presidents. Four, to develop a better understanding between the UGS and BIMCO, given that the Greek ship owners constitute approximately one-third of the BIMCO members. Fifth, to produce a number of important practical and balance clauses, like the use of low sulfur fuel. Dear friends, in the end of this concise summary of my trajectory in shipping, I would like to share with you a few concluding thoughts. First, we managed to survive and thrive in shipping because we are hardworking, eternal optimists. Second, we can face the future with confidence because the next generation of shipping entrepreneurs and professionals who will succeed us are better educated and have a broader global vision. Third, the new technologies available, properly utilized, will improve the operations and optimize the results of the sector. Ladies and gentlemen, I try to narrate my travel in the magic world of shipping. However, I intentionally avoided to mention anything about my misconceptions and wrong decisions. This could be a much more entertaining, long, and exciting story. I decided to spare you of that experience for two main reasons. First, you would have a much shorter time for drinks and networking. And second, the organizers of the conference might change their mind about the winner of the Capital Link Award 2019. Thank you very much.